Hello and welcome to this video tutorial. My name is Sven Goldstein and I'm product manager for our TwinCAD automation software and responsible for our connectivity world. In this video tutorial, I would like to show you how to get started with our TF6100 OPC UA client. For this video tutorial, I have prepared a virtual machine on which I have already installed the either 4D24 setup, meaning the TF6100 OPC UA client setup, or the corresponding 4D26 workload. So in this video tutorial, we would like to connect a TwinCAD OPC UA client to an OPC UA server in order to read some variables from it. And as an OPC UA server, we would like to use the sample server that is getting automatically installed with our setup. And you can find and start the sample server on the Windows Start menu. So there is a folder called Backoff, and within that folder, you can start the TF6100 OPC UA sample server. So the sample server, when it starts, it gives you a quick message box here, which you can just ignore and click on close. And the sample server will then open a TCP port, and which you can use to connect to it using the corresponding endpoint URL opc.tcp/localhost48030. So the server is now started running in the background, offering some variables, and we would now like to connect to the server using the TwinCAD OPC UA client. So let's minimize this window. And I have prepared a TwinCAD XAE, which contains a TwinCAD project here with a PLC project. And we now would like to add a TwinCAD OPC UA client. So we navigate to the IO area of TwinCAD. We right click on the devices node and we select add new item. And within the device list, you will find a category called OPC UA, and there you will find a so-called virtual OPC UA device, which we would like to add. So select this virtual OPC UA device, click on OK. And on that virtual OPC UA device, we would like to add a client. So right-click this virtual OPC UA device, select Add New Item. Select the OPC UA client module here, and click on OK. So this OPC UA client should now be connected to the sample server, so which means we need to configure the client to use the endpoint URL of that sample server. So we enter the URL here using the same URL that we have seen in the on the terminal using the port 48030. So after that, we would like to select an endpoint from the server that we would like our client to connect to. So, and the server only has one endpoint, so we select that endpoint here from the endpoint list. We click on OK. And after that, we can click on the Add Nodes button, which opens a namespace browser that we can use to navigate through the server address space and select the variables that we would like to read. So on the sample server, you will find a folder called sample. And in that folder, we will have some variables and objects that we can just add to our project here. So in this case, I'm selecting these three variables. I click on OK. And what happens then is that those variables are being automatically added to the process image of our OPC UA client device here. So you can now go ahead to either link those variables manually with existing PLC variables, or you can also start our automatic code generation. And you will find the automatic code generation button on the OPC UA client. Within its settings, you will find a so-called create PLC code button. And if you trigger this button, we will automatically generate a global variable list in the PLC project. And this global variable list here contains not only status code variables from the OPC UA client itself, so meaning whether the client is connected to the server, what is the status of the state machine of the client. So all this information can be found here. But we also have variables for our three variables that we for our three OPC UA nodes that we have just added. And those variables are automatically linked to the OPC UA nodes using the TC link to attribute. So before we activate this project here, we just want to make sure that we have a TF6100 license. So we switch to the Twinkit License Manager and we make sure that a TF6100 license is active. In this case, we have a trial license, which is perfectly fine, which runs without any restrictions for 7 days, and then you can reactivate it. So that's totally fine. The second thing that we want to make sure is if we go to our global variable list, because we want to see the variables in online view, we need to make sure that the property here, the always link property, is set to true. If this is not the case, please make sure that this property is set to true. We will do that automatically in an upcoming version of the Twinkit OPC UA client, but for now we have to manually set this to true so that we can use the online view. So now we're all set and we want to activate our configuration. If it asks you for switching Twinkit to run mode, this is of course what we want to do. So we're restarting Twinkit, switching it to run mode, and then we want to log into our global variable list. So here we go. Our Twinkit OPC UA client is now connected to the server, and we see the values of the three variables within our global variables that have been linked to the corresponding nodes on our I/O device here. So that was it. That's all it requires to get started with our Twinkit OPC UA client. I hope that this information was useful to you. And yeah, thank you very much for watching and see you around. Thank you. Bye-bye.